Hey guys, it's Andy here from ROVE, and today we're gonna make a video about how to troubleshoot an issue about the GPS with your ROVE R3 dash cam. So let's get right to it. So before I actually turn on the ROVE R3 dash cam, I actually want to go show you the mount. So the mount is in the back side of the ROVE R3, and to remove it, it's very easy. I want you guys to understand first that the GPS antenna for ROVE R3 is actually inside this mount, right over here behind this. So why did we do that? Because we wanted to make a product that a lot of customers with ROVE R3 stated that sometimes it takes a long time to get the signal for GPS with an R2 4K dash cam. So when we were designing this, hey, we could get a better GPS antenna and actually put it in the mount. And that way we can get a more faster, accurate GPS data for your ROVE R3 dash cam. Having said that, let's put the mount back in the ROVE R3. So to understand that, guys, the GPS antenna is in the mount. Now, when the power goes through the mount, the antenna gets processed, gets the signal, and it sends that signal through the processor. The processor is not in the mount. The processor is inside the dash cam, right? So the most people who actually reach out to us stating, hey, I'm not having a GPS signal with my R3. So most of the time, the reason is they're not getting it is because right now in this video you can see it, but actually when you mount it in your car, you don't see the back side of your ROVE R3. So this is what I want to show you. A lot of you guys, what happens is when the mount is there, you slide your dash cam like that, and you try to press it, and it doesn't go any further, and then you guys leave it. Now, I want you guys to see what you have done is you have left a gap. You haven't locked the mount completely into an R3. So let me show you that the mount can actually go further. See that? So now this is a proper lock. So many of you guys are reaching out to us stating that, hey guys, I'm having a problem with the GPS with my R3. So the very first thing we want you guys to do is make sure to take a look from top, either take a photo or somehow figure out a way to ensure that when you slide the camera, it's locked and clicked in place like that. Okay guys, so now on this one, I was able to make the problem show up. So as you could see, there is a gap over here on the mount. All right, that means the mount is not all the way locked in place. Having said that, the camera is still working. It's recording, you could say it's recording right there, okay? So what is really happening, guys, is the context of the mount is barely just touching to the camera. Now, because the GPS antenna is in the mount and it is only barely touching, it actually is not having the data transfer. The signal it's acquiring is not able to transfer the data properly because the processor is in the dash cam. Now, if we take a look, there is a GPS icon is missing. It's supposed to be right there. Okay, having said that, I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. And what I'm going to do, if I can catch it in this video, I'm just going to push the mount in a little bit and keep an eye on these icons right here. And also keep an eye on this gap and see what happens as soon as I do it. There you go. Now, you could see the GPS icon just appear right away. And because I'm in my office and by the window, the GPS got the lock right away. So that is what I wanted to show you guys. The majority of the problem, the reason you don't have the GPS is because there is a gap in your mount. And let's see if I can try to do it again. Okay, so what people are happening right now, you can see this, but when you're trying to mount it, you only see the camera like that. So when this is just barely touching it, the camera turns on. See, there is no GPS icon. So sometimes you will have it, sometimes you won't have it, based on the how strong or poor the connection is. So to make sure that you have a proper connection, always lock in place, and look, the GPS icon showed up right away. All right, guys, I hope this video was helpful, and that it helps you solve your GPS issue with your ROVE R3 dash cam. Once again, guys, we hope that you're loving your ROVE R3 dash cam as much as we do. If you have any questions or concerns or need any kind of help, please feel free to reach out to us. We are here for you, and thank you. Be safe and cheers.